This is Nam. I am a passionate Java programmer who loves Java programming. I am the founder of the website called java.net, which is one of the most popular Java tutorial sites. You know, my mission is to help you become a good Java programmer. Today, I'm going to show you how to write the first Java program using Eclipse IDE. So let's start by downloading Eclipse IDE. We go to eclipse.org. You know, Eclipse is the most popular IDE for Java development. As you can see, the latest release of Eclipse today is a Neon version. There are two kinds of setups for Eclipse. The first one is a installer. If you click the download, it will download the installer, and if we click the other package download, we will download zip files. I prefer package download, so click other package download. And as you can see, Eclipse has many flavors, many versions. And for Java beginner, I recommend you choose Eclipse IDE for Java developers or Eclipse IDE for Java EE developers. But I recommend you choose Java EE developers, because sooner or later you will use this IDE for developing a web application using Java. And choose the best version according to the operating system. Here I choose a 64-bit version. So click here. Here we see a list of mirror size. Choose the fast mirror size near you. Here I choose IBM and click on Windows 64-bit to download the package file. Is around 300 megabytes. Okay, so we wait until the download completes, and we have a zip file look like this. I extract here. Okay, and this is a extracted directory. Here are the install files of the Eclipse release we've downloaded. And to run Eclipse, we double click on the eclipse.exe file. I double click here. You see the splash screen of Eclipse Neon appears, and the first time you start Eclipse, it asks for directory as a workspace. You can imagine that workspace is a group of related projects. It is actually a directory on your computer, and by default Eclipse choose the user home as the location for its workspace. We can choose another directory. Click browse, and I choose another directory for my workspace for Java development. Here I choose djava. Okay, and if you don't want to be asked again, check this option, and you can always choose a switch workspace during Eclipse running. So I click OK to continue. You see, this is the welcome screen of the Eclipse IDE. Close the welcome tab, and this is the main interface of the Eclipse IDE. You also have to get yourself familiar with the perspective concept. Perspective is a predefined configuration that is specific for doing an aspect in development. For example, you can see some old perspective here: Java perspective, Java EE perspective, debug perspective, and so on. Because we are going to write a Hello World Java program, so I choose the Java perspective. Okay, you see, and you can also change perspective by click on the icon on the icon on the right here. Here is the Java EE perspective, and here is the Java perspective. Okay. Anytime you want to change perspective, and go to the menu window perspective and choose open perspective and choose other and select the perspective you want to switch. For example, I choose debug perspective. Okay. And you see Eclipse arranged a set of icons related for debugging Java application. Now I switch back to Java perspective. Okay. Now we are going to create a Java project. Go to menu file, new Java project. Okay. In this new Java project dialog, you enter the project name, Hello World. Okay. You can choose the execution environment for the application. Here it is Java SE 1.844. Okay. That's it, and leave. Just name the project and leave other as default and click finish. And you see the new project appear here. And next we create a package, a Java package. Right click on the project, new, and choose package. And enter the package name. Here I enter the package name is net.co.java. Because it's my website, and click finish. Next, we are going to create a Java class. Right click on the package you want to create a class in, and select new class from the context menu. Here is a new Java class dialog. Enter the name of the class, Hello World. Okay, and check the option, this option public static void main, to generate the main method for the class. Okay, then click finish. You see Eclipse generates the skeleton code for the Hello World class, at you can see on the screen. And now we write something here, system.out.println, Hello World, Hello World. Okay. and save the files. You can see Eclipse automatically compiles the code as we type. If there is any error, compiler will see the error appears in the problems view. For example, I change something here and save. You see Eclipse will instantly report the error in the problem views. Now I change back to the correct method and you will see the error disappear. Okay. You can change the auto view by click on the menu project and uncheck the option view automatically. But I strongly recommend you to view automatically because it will help you detect compilers instantly when you type the code in the editor. Okay, so that's it. This is a simple Hello World Java program, and now let's run it. To run the Java program, go to run, select run, and you see the program print Hello World in the console view very quickly. Okay. Now let's try to add something. System.out. Okay, no problem. .println. Welcome to CodeJava.net and save the file and click run again. You can click on the run icon here. Oh, you see? The program prints Hello World and welcome to CodeJava.net in the console. That's it. You will have done creating and running your first Java program using the Eclipse IDE. I hope this video tutorial is helpful for you in terms of getting familiar with Eclipse IDE and Java programming. Thank you for watching.